Tonight is the mid-season report card, and I am going to have to pick up a team that I said tank going, and they're going to be going. So it's right to rescind. And I'm picking up the Lakers. Purple Nation, especially you, BD Amos, I apologize. I'm sorry. I didn't see this coming. So back in the day, buddy.
Yes, Master.
Open up that can.
Woo-hoo!
Welcome you all to another edition of Around the Rim. I am your host, the Dudster, Nestor Dudley. And before I get into the mid-season report card, I just got to get a little something off my chest. Back in the day, buddy, can you hear me? Okay, last week we were on hashtag hiatus because it was the annual Triple Threat Trivia fundraiser for the Marlin Public Library. So I was on team MATV, along with Sharon Sofit, usually back in the day, buddy, but something came up at the extreme last moment, so he could not be with us. So again, this is a fundraiser for the Marlin Public Library. So in the first, this fundraiser has three rounds, and it has two components. It has the best costume component, and it also has the winner of the trivia component. So best costume, trivia. So we was dressed as the casino, as Everett Casino, because we know that the Wynn Casino's coming to Everett in mere months from now. So in the first round of the Triple Threat Trivia, it was the show and tell portion. So they showed a video clip. They showed a video clip of a movie. And the movie was The Black Panther. And the question was, in what fictional African nation did this movie take place in? So I knew the answer, Guillermo, who was on team MATV, he knew the answer. There were several people in the audience that knew this answer. So it wasn't that I was unique with this answer. By the way, I just want to say that everything I'm about to say now, I'm not representing MATV, I'm not representing anybody else, I'm just representing myself, the Dudster, Nestor Dudley. So if anybody gets mad because they don't want to hear the truth, you can just tweet at me. Just tweet at me. I'll have you on the show, we'll talk about it. But in any case, so they showed the video clip, and the question was, in what fictional African nation did this take place in? So I told Ron Cox, who's the executive director of MATV, I said, Ron, however much that you're comfortable bidding for this point, you can bid that. I should back up a little bit. This was, again, a fundraiser, so you had to bid to get this particular point, and the highest bidder earned the opportunity to answer this question. So MATV was the high bidder with $160. Again,
Esther?
Yes.
Just want to reiterate. This was for charity.
This was for charity.
Just want to make sure.
This is for charity. It's a fundraiser for the Marlin Library.
Okay.
For charity.
Fundraiser.
All good. Fundraiser.
Library.
All good.
Okay. Okay. Continue.
So MATV bid $160. So MATV won the bid for the right, for the opportunity for that loan point. So when they said, okay, MATV, answer the question. Ron said, Nesta, why don't you answer the question? So I jumped up on the mic and said, Wakanda Forever. A round of applause. The place erupted. The roof blew the roof off. Everyone was laughing at all this stuff. Yeah, high-fiving and stuff. Again, this is for charity. It's a fundraiser. So there was this table that challenged the answer because the Dudster said Wakanda with a pause forever. Challenged the answer. Now, I do not blame the table for challenging the answer. Okay, I'm going on the record right now. Do not blame that table. If it was the other way around, I would have challenged the answer because this is America. You can ask for anything. Don't mean that you're going to get it, but you can ask for anything. So it went to the challenge master. So we figure, okay, we got this in the bag. So the challenge master comes over and says that we were disqualified from that point because the fictional country is not called Wakanda Forever. At first, I thought he was ribbing, but we all found out that this dude was deadly serious. So he says, you know, you gotta listen to me. This is what I says goes. The name of the movie is Wakanda. And I said, no, you are incorrect. The name of the movie is Black Panther. The fictional nation, the fictional country is Wakanda, and their battle cry is Wakanda Forever. And that's what I tried to explain to this man, to this challenge master. Asked the challenge master, did he see this movie? He didn't answer the question. It was obvious that he did not see this movie. So Guillermo, who also knew the answer, Guillermo said, well, can we challenge the challenge master? And that's the challenge master got indignant. You cannot challenge the challenge master. What the challenge master says goes, and that's not the right answer. So you have been disqualified. How dare you try to challenge the challenge master? So we lost that point. We got hosed. MATV got hosed. The crowd is booing. Again, this is a fundraiser, a charity for the Marlin Public Library. I had gone into the bathroom after the first round. I was cool because I knew I was going to rebut on tonight's show. A couple of guys in the bathroom did not see the movie, asked me what was going on, and I told them what was going on. They said, you got hosed. And I see community people, dignitaries saying, hey, Nestor, you got hosed. Everybody said, Nestor, you got hosed. The table that challenged came over and said, you know, I'm sorry, I apologize. I said, there's nothing for you to apologize for. I would have done the same thing. It was up to the challenge master. The challenge master had one job to do, and he failed to do it properly. Just failed, complete failure. In any case, I got that off my chest. So no more taking up the valuable time of that. But I got the last word. Now on to the mid-season report card. The team that's on top of the league right now, the Celtics. The Celtics are undefeated. The Celtics are 5-0. The Celtics are exactly who we thought they are. 5-0, that half-court offense, that motion offense. That ball just swings between each player. They all eight players, they got eight players on this team. All eight players contribute, and you go down that roster, Stefan Cherenfant, Ari Cohen, Simon DePonta, Wichie Pierre-René, Sean Kelley, Bruce Kellington, Chen Nguyen, Sebastian Joseph, head coach Mighty Joe Young, Evans the Magic Man Revere is the assistant coach, and the Celtics weapons, Sean Kelley, Cherenfant, Cohen, Joseph. That is a solid, solid squad. First place have yet to taste defeat. They played just about every team thus far. They have not played the Kings yet. They're not going to play the Kings until later on in the season. They're going to play the Kings twice within 2 weeks and possibly a third week, including the postseason. The Celtics ain't happy about it. The Kings ain't happy about it either. But in any case, the Celtics, again, they are who we thought they were. The team that's in second place, the Lakers, the purple and gold. I did not see this at the Jamboree, which is why. And if you go to the first show of this season, the season premiere, which you can stream on our website, atrlive.com, or you can go to our YouTube channel, Nestor Dudley, Around the Rim, and subscribe. We only have or need 41 more subscribers to get to our goal of 100 subscribers. So the Lakers did not have, they didn't graduate. Two of their weapons went on to play Marlin High School varsity ball, and then their third weapon, Wes Johnson, has his hand in the cast, broke his hand. But everybody else has certainly picked up the slack. Javinsky Baptiste, Jordan Bridgman Dix, Hakeem Jean Baptiste, as I said, Wesley Johnson, Kinsley Odovan, A.J. Pickney, Friendly Jean, Gabriel Jermay, Jeffrey Joseph. The Lakers did not look good in the Jamboree, but that was the last time that the Lakers did not look good. I can honestly say that the Lakers have the best defense in the Marlin Neighborhood Basketball League, being led by Dix, Bridgman Dix, Jermay, Baptiste, Odovan, Jean Baptiste, a solid squad. I apologize, Purple Nation. I apologize to you, BD Amos. You haven't talked to me, you haven't tweeted at me since the season premiere. So, like I said, I didn't see it coming. I'm sorry. The team that is in third place, the Kings, Wakanda Forever. The team that is in third place, the Kings. I said the Kings was going to be there. I said that the Kings were going. I said the Kings were going to finish in second place. Now, the Kings have two losses. They have a loss against those Pistons, and the Pistons are a dangerous, dangerous squad when they put it all together. And the Kings loses to the Lakers last weekend, and that game, playoff atmosphere, the lead changed back and forth several times, but this Kings has a solid, solid squad featuring Muhammad, Aishat the Cherif, Salim Tekin, Fernando Pedro, Jeffrey Song, same song, Jaden Brito White, Adam Chen, Dominic Bono, Jason Chan, Woody Raphael, Chris Rogers, head coach, Cliff Williams, Sebastian Arano are the assistants. And again, this team, this Kings team, this is a solid team. They know their basketball. They coach well. They appear to me to be just all good kids, just great kids. Chan, Cherif, Tekin, Song are the leaders, are the weapons, are the guns on this team, the Kings. The team that is in fourth place, the Sonics. The Sonics are where I thought they would be, teetering around fourth place, and I predicted they were going to have a lock, a strong one on fourth place. That's what I said at the season premiere. The Sonics, coached by Cliff Philippe, with major, major support by Team Mama and he honey, Liz. This roster of nine, Xavier Serrano, Alan Claude, Yemen Jalal, Darius Philippe, who is the son of head coach Cliff Philippe, Joshua Serrano, Jonah Tensezar, Tenzin Shakya, Paul Huang, and Kevin Portillo. Let me tell you how talented this Sonics team is and how well coached this is. This Sonics team has done what no team has ever done in the 34-year history of the Mall Neighborhood Basketball League. The Sonics, a couple of weekends are gone, and if you watch the show, the second show this year, you will know this, so this will just be a repeat. The Sonics won game against the Sixers. The Sonics only had four players. Now, all the coaches a couple of seasons are gone put in the rule books that you can start with four players because kids come home, these players come home from work and whatnot, and sometimes they're not there at the beginning of the game, so usually they come after the game has started. So the Sonics had four players. The Sixers had five, and I believe that they had one person on the bench. So the Sonics playing 4-on-5 the entire game, and back in the day, buddy, as you know, the Sonics defeated the Sixers 5-on-4. Now, why the Sixers did not pound the rock in the paint? This reporter cannot answer that question, but the Sonics, that's how talented and well-coached this team is, the Sonics. Our defending Neighborhood League champ, the Bullets, come in the fifth slot. Bullets roster, Bill Chen, Jordan Kelley, Antonio Jonas, Mark Henley Noel, Junho May, Burton Dorvillier, Nico Soares, Matt Millen. This is a talented squad. They're the defending Neighborhood League champs, and we all know that when you are the champs, you have a natural target on your back, and this team welcomes that target. Steve Wright, head coach, day one, made his game debut last weekend. Mark Gagnon, Eric Ribeiro holding it down. Your defending Neighborhood League champs, the Bullets. Slow start, dangerous team, fundamentally sound. We've had yet to see that Bullets half-court offense, and Steve Wright, who was here on our last Showtime, says that that half-court offense and that defense will all come together around games 7, 8, 9. The team in the next position are the Pistons. This Pistons team is a very talented team. It has weapons down their roster, their 10-man roster. Mark Naibo, Jason Azmed, Terrell Stringer, Nick Cornet, Emi Doltre, Jamal, Gene Jacques, Kenny Williams, Trey Cabral, Jonathan Brown, Roberto Dangfeng, first-year head coach, but not new to this league, certainly, Marcus Bailey, along with Anthony Guerrero and Chuck Washington. This Piston squad, again, is a talented, talented squad being led by Mark Naibo, third-year senior, Stringer, Cornet, Williams, a very, very tough squad. And they got 10 players. So that means that they got plenty of fresh legs to rotate during in that game. Now, the team that is in the seventh slot are the Hawks. And the Hawks are around where we thought that they were going to be around. Nine-man roster, Kevin Patel, Luis Gomez, David Jean-Pierre, June Ling, Joseph Tu, Connor Kavanaugh, Lewinsky, Doris Mann, Andy Nguyen, Gabriel Morales. I'm getting a text right now, but everybody knows that it's around the rib time. I'm getting this text. Now, if it was a tweet, that'd be fine, but don't text me. Tweet at me if anything. Tweet at me, we can have a conversation. Tweet at Nesta Dudley, hashtag ATR, and we can have a conversation. No text, I want to tweet. Head coach Legerian LJ Long and Ali Joseph, who was on the Perfect Dynasty back in the year 2010 and 2011. The Hawks, this is a tough season for them. This is going to be a rebuilding season. But the coaches knew that this was going to be a rebuilding season, so the Hawks have been steadily improving week after week. And the team that is bringing up the rear, the Sixers, and this Sixers team has had this theme for the past few seasons. Very talented, can beat any team, but sometimes internal grumblings, they seem more interested in arguing with themselves than to take it out on their opponents. Eight-man squad, we have Linsky George, Jonathan Berlis, Anthony Bayers, Josca Mendez, Max Retzmichi, Ricardo St. Jean, Miguel Lopes, Adam Elbalawan. Again, very talented team. This team has yet to see their first victory. Head coach Chris Callanan, Anthony Lopez, John Johnson, and Sean Hickey. This team, they are well coached. The players know where they need to be. They are fundamentally sound, but they, this far, has not demonstrated the ability to put together four consecutive strong quarters. So again, the Sixers are where I thought they would be, which would be outside the Madness. I did not see this team being on the schneid thus far, but in any case, on to this last past weekend's play. I love that Planet Rock phrase. On to the past weekend's play. The week of January 26th. The first game, Sonics versus the Hawks, and the Sonics defeated the Hawks 57-41. Ling Hyman for the Hawks, 16 points. Jalal led all scores with 31 points as the Sonics improved to 3-2. Hawks dropped to 1-4. Game number two Saturday, Kings Bullets. Kings 6 points better than the Bullets, 47-41. Chen, Hyman for the Bullets, 10 points. Tyken led all scores with 11 points as the Kings improved to 3-1. The Bullets dropped to the reciprocal 1-3. Third and final game for Saturday, Pistons, Lakers, and that was a close game. That was a barn burner. Lakers 2 points better than the Pistons, 48-46. Stringer, Hyman for the Pistons, 15 points. Jermaine led all scores with 18 points as the Lakers improved to 4-1. The Pistons dropped to 2-3. First game Sunday, Bullets, Pistons. Bullets 45, Pistons 36. Dorvillier, Hyman for the Pistons, 14 points. Naibo led all scores with 16 points as the Bullets improved to 2-3. The Pistons dropped to 2-4. Next game, which was certainly the game of the weekend, Lakers 3 points better than the Kings, 51-49. Chen, Hyman for the Kings, 15 points. Jermaine led all scores with 19 points. As the Lakers improved to 5-1, the Kings dropped to 3-2. And the third and final game Sunday, the Celtics versus the Sixers. The Celtics, 10 points better than the Sixers, 69-59. Kelley, Hyman for the Celtics, 27 points. But St. Jean just went crazy, led all scores with 34 points as the Celtics still portrait of a perfect season, 5-0, and the Sixers dropped to 0-5, the exact reciprocal of the record. And that's how everything went down this past weekend's play. And now for your weekly Around the Rim Awards. So let's kick it! Player of the Week, Sean Kelley of those Celtics. Now, I'm going to tell you, Player of the Week, this week for the Player of the Week was very difficult because it was a choice of three, but one was already Player of the Week. So then I had to whittle it down to two, and it was very hard to choose who would be Player of the Week. But Sean Kelley gets the Player of the Week this week. Coach of the Week, Steve Wright of the Bullets. First day in the house, and the Bullets captured that victory. Steve Wright using all his timeouts, as he always does. Coach of the Week, Steve Wright. Team of the Week goes to those Lakers. Those Lakers down by 7 points and a half to the Pistons Saturday. Down in the third period by 14 points, was able to come back and win that game by 2 points. And then Sunday, playing the Kings, the Lakers started off with four guys, and the Kings could not capitalize on the first 3 to 5 minutes of that game. The Kings, for some reason that I don't know why, did not pound the rock and down low, but the Lakers came out with a double victory this past weekend. And Wooo of the Week goes to Ricardo St. Jean. He was the other person that was in consideration for Player of the Week. So Ricardo St. Jean with those 34 points translated to 6 2-pointers, 6 3-pointers, and 4 for 4 at the line where everything is free. I'm going to say this again. 4 for 4 at the line where everything is free. So Ricardo St. Jean, perfect at the line, and it all counts. Hell, you're not being guarded at all. This Wooo is for you. Wooo! And now on to the weekly standings. Remember, if it doesn't match this, it just ain't official. Right now, the Celtics on top of the league, 5-0, followed by the Lakers, 5-1. Kings, Sonics, both 3-2. The Kings are in the third slot. The Bullets, 2-3. The Pistons, 2-4. The Hawks got a victory last weekend, 1-4. And the Sixers, unfortunately for them, bringing up the rear at 0-5. This weekend's game's coming up. The first game, the Bullets up against the Celtics at 1:15, followed at 2:30 by the Kings versus the Sixers, and 3:45, that third game, the Lakers versus the Hawks. And in that first game, hashtag, can the champs beat the undefeated? Well, we'll find out. Sunday's game, the first game is Bullets versus the Sixers, second game is Celtics versus Hawks, and the third game is Pistons versus the Sonics. I want you to pay attention to these times. These times, they all start 1 hour earlier. So that first game is 12:15 start, followed by game number 2, 1:30, and then the third game is 2:45. And why? Because it's hashtag Super Bowl 53, where our New England Patriots take on the LA Rams. Who's going to win? Will it be New England to continue the dynasty? TB and Belichick, 9th Super Bowl, going for their 6th ring? Or will it be the Rams? Now remember, the Rams was the first quote-unquote victim of the dynasty. Life has a way of going full circle. So could it be full circle and the Rams win? I can see a scenario where the Rams also win. Tune in, Super Bowl. Where to read them? Every week in the Malden Advocate. The paper is free for the cheap, 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 cheap. Or if you want to follow the MNBL while the new website is under construction, the MNBL, we are on Instagrams at MNBL. I do that every week. At MNBL 1986. Or you can go to the online show, the online home of this show, ATRLive.com. Around the Rim, when you can watch them on the public channel, Comcast 3, Verizon 28, live every Thursday night, 6 in the p.m. Plus, it replays Friday night, 10 in the p.m., followed by an additional replay the following Wednesday afternoon at 3 p.m., all on MATV, Malden's Media Center. Like and stream on Facebook, Around the Rim, hashtag follow, hashtag stream, hashtag retweet, Twitter, at Nesta Dudley, or Instagrams, at The Real Nesta Dudley, because back in the day, buddy, there's only one Nesta Dudley. around the rim, you can stream ATR on all devices, live or VOD. ATRlive.com is the website. And subscribe to our YouTube channel, ATR on YouTube. Search YouTube, Nestor Dudley, Around the Rim. We are only 41 subscribers away from our goal of 100 subscribers. Please subscribe. That'll be much appreciated. My mic sounds nice. Test one. My mic sounds nice. Test two. BTR mic. Beyond the Rim, the podcast. BTR mic is the, oh, there's that music I love. Beyond the Rim, the podcast. BTRmic.com. That is a website. So you want to, that's the other adventure that we do here. So at the website, BTRmic.com, where the episodes are downloadable. We are also available on iTunes, wherever you get your podcast, on your favorite podcast app, or also go to YouTube and subscribe to the YouTube page, Beyond the Rim. Now, in our last waning minutes, by this clock out here, I got less than 4 minutes. So again, I am using my right to rescind. So what the right to rescind is that if enacted on the season premiere, which is what I did, I can take one team that I said tank going and put them in the going, and I can take one team that I said was going and it just tank going. So as I started off at the top of the show, I said that the Lakers were going. So what team tank going? Your defending neighborhood league champs, the Bullets. I'm sorry, guys, you're not going to successfully defend your title. The Bullets just tank going. And I threw them real far. They're not even on the stage. I don't think they're going to like that. So I have the four teams that are going, which are the top four teams. I got the Celtics. The Celtics are going. I got the Lakers. Oh, boy, the boys in purple and gold are going. The Kings. Yes, the Kings are still going. And the Sonics are going to hang in there, and the Sonics are going to be going. So who is going to match up with who? Well, the Sonics got fourth place on a lock. Lock, boom. So now there's going to be a mess. It's going to be jumbled up at the top slot. As I see these three teams virtually finishing with like the same record. So we're going to go head to head. And when you go head to head, it's going to be the Celtics that's going to have the number one slot. So that means Lakers, Kings, it doesn't matter if the Lakers are in second and the Kings are in third, or the Kings are in second and the Lakers are in third. It doesn't matter because the playoff format in the Madness, one plays four and two plays three. So in that first game between the Celtics and the Sonics, I see the Sonics. That's right, the Sonics. The Sonics is going to be in the lead that entire game. The Celtics are not going to come back to until like within the last 5 minutes of the game. Then the Celtics are going to take a two-point lead, and the Celtics are going to foul a Sonic, any Sonic whose name is not Josh Serrano. I'm going to repeat this. They're going to foul a Sonic whose name is not Josh Serrano with no time left on the clock. The Celtics are going to be up by 1 point, and that person, whoever gets fouled, is going to go to the line where everything is free on the court by himself because the time has run out. Palm's going to be sweaty, butt cheek's going to be tight. He's going to clang them both, and the Celtics are going to go on to the big dance. The Kings and the Lakers, this game is going to go overtime where each team has a weapon that's going to foul out. But when it's all said and done, the Lakers are going to advance past the Kings. And then we got the Lakers and we got the Celtics. And this game is going to go overtime. But when it's all settled and done, it's going to be the people in gold that's going to win. So you see, Beanie, I hope you like that better. The Lakers are going to be your champs. Until next time, buenas noches, hoochas, coochas. I came in peace. I leave with love. This is for the red, the black, and the green. And I'll be seeing you at the games. Wakanda forever.